Hey guys, welcome back to another new video. Dereck reacts, back at it again. You read right, R.E.M. Yes, taking it back to 1993 with Nightswimming. Looking forward to this recommendation made by Patreon subscribers. Let's check it out. And that's what I'm going to do. I'll be taking a look at the official video. Can't wait to get my hands on this. R.E.M. for the first time on Dereck reacts. Yes, guys. Before we get into the video, please take a moment, comment, like, and subscribe. I'd love to hear your feedback. Makes videos like these all the more possible. And also take a moment to follow me and like me, both on Instagram and on Facebook. And if you're new to the channel, guys, welcome. I also have a Patreon link down below. Be sure to check that out when you get a chance. Help support my channel. Makes recommendations like the one you're about to watch all the more possible. All right, guys, without further ado, let's go.
Night swimming deserves a quiet night. With photograph on the dashboard taken years ago, turned around backwards so the windshield shows every street light.
Wow, this is so interesting. Very interesting type of song. Very unusual in its own way. Not necessarily bad. It's just it has its own way of. It's just very, very unique in it. And even his voice is unique to its sound. You know, when he sings, you kind of just know who it is just by the way he sounds. Has a very unique voice. Video is a little strange. We're seeing like different kind of like different scenes, different types of like, I guess like themes or different like circumstances, different little the parts that kind of like daily lifestyle type of like circumstances and stuff. But those pianos, guys, that piano is being smashed completely. And also interesting use of violins and strings in the beginning there. Kind of like in some orchestration there in the beginning. Really interesting so far. Different, unlike anything I've heard of in a while. So very descriptive in lyrical content too.
Still it's so much clearer. I forgot my shirt at the water's edge. The moon is low tonight.
How beautiful is that?
Night swimming deserves a quiet night. I'm not sure all these people understand. Huh. It's not like years ago. Fear of getting caught. But recklessness. Water.
Notice the lyrical content. Notice the lyrical content of what he's singing here about. Night swimming deserves a quiet night. I'm not sure if all these people understand. It's not like years ago, the fear of getting caught, of recklessness and water. And they cannot see me naked. These things, they go away, replaced by every day. This is the second verse. This song structure is very interesting. It's almost very storytelling type of delivery that he has against the piano. And then you have those inner moment between the first verse and the second verse where it's just the piano and then the strings coming in really, really nicely. Why does this song have kind of this nostalgic type of like appeal? Almost like very kind of like, oh, I remember those days, right? Like, I think of, like, the Wonder Years. I don't know why. Like, that the show, the Wonder Years. I don't know if you guys have seen that show before. Like, you just, like, it's a reflective type of song. You think about, like, a circumstance or a time that you were in. Bringing back those memories. That's what it feels like. It has kind of, like, that type of, that thought behind it. Very interesting.
They cannot see me naked. They go away, replaced pass by every day. Night swimming, remembering that night. September's coming soon. I'm pining for the moon. And what if there were two, side by side in orbit, around the fairest sun? The bright tide ever drowned.
Notice his voice cracked. His voice cracked there. Very interesting. He has a very interesting tone. That piano has the same kind of like the same key, the keys being played, keystrokes being played all the way through in that same rhythm. But when it gets to that point, there's a nice little flow to it that makes it really, really catchy against the ears when you hear it, specifically when he starts singing. Really, really good. This is one of those songs. It kind of like just takes you back. I mean, that's what it is. That's what it is all the way. You probably would be thinking by now, just by what he's singing, that it has to do with skinny dipping at night, because of the lyrical content. But there's other different meanings too that could be taken into consideration. I love the strings. I think the strings and the piano, I mean, those are the two prominent, you know, type of sounds that we get. There's really nothing else. You're not getting guitars or anything like that. So really, really interesting. Nice ballad. Nice ballad. And you get all those elements from his voice to highlight and tell this almost like a story. It's almost like a story, but it's very descriptive too.
Not describe night swimming. You, I thought I knew you. You, I cannot judge. You, I thought you knew me. This one laughing quietly underneath my breath. Wow. Night swimming.
Oh, the piano stops. Oh. Beautiful, beautiful. It's just beautifully done. It's beautifully done. The instrumentation, most definitely. Just so great. Bassist Mike Mills recalled that he was playing a piano riff at a John Keane studio in the band's hometown of Athens, Georgia. And while Mills almost discarded the medley, it attracted the interest of Michael Stipe. And Mills said, "I never thought that it would amount to so much because it's just a circular thing that kept going round and round and round, but it inspired Michael." And it's that piano, it just, if you notice, it's very, very attractive. Very, very attractive. And it has this nice little rhythm to it that it's circular in fashion. It just always turns around and comes back. But it's just good on the ears. And then you have it. Now we're getting the violins come back in again in this part. And the video itself is very, very self-explanatory. I don't have to really go into depth about it, but that's what we're getting here, guys. That's what we're getting. And you know, who says rock bands can't do ballads? Are you kidding me? Look at it. Here it is right here, guys. Here it is.
Photograph reflects every street light, a reminder. Night swimming deserves a quiet night.
Love it.
Deserves a quiet night.
Beautiful. This is one of those type of songs that can get easily covered, most definitely. I think if someone were to cover this, they would probably cover it and probably maybe tweak it here and there, or maybe do it in their own way. But the piano, very, very circular, very, very circular, like I mentioned, and like how the bassist mentioned it. It's very, very attractive, and it just sounds good. Very, very ballady, very, very heartfelt type of thing. Lyrical content too. And even his voice against it, it works so well. It's done well. Now we're getting more strings too, to almost like kind of like wrap this one up. It's just good all the way around. All the way around, it's good. Oh, so nice. Look at that. And like the store closes off and stuff like that. Very interesting video. There it is at Athens. Interesting video here, 1983, 90s. Kind of like one of those songs where it just takes you back. It takes you back into a time, a certain time, and a certain time and place. And you know, if you were hearing it at around this time, or even in the late 90s you were hearing it, you're probably thinking of something that took place, or at least, you know, oh, I was here, I was there. That happens with music. And that's the interesting thing about music, that you play a certain song, you play something, and you're like, wow, this reminds me of that. I remember, I'm going off a little topic here, but going into the city, in the New York City, when I was younger with my parents, seeing relatives, I would be playing a lot of 80s dance stuff, a lot of 80s dance stuff. And you guys know that I love that stuff, like freestyle, a lot of 80s freestyle stuff. And every time I would be hearing this freestyle 80s dance stuff like that, I would think of the city. I would think of New York every time. And every time I would play it, I would think of it, like TKA and all that. I used to love all that stuff. And that's why I don't really react to those things like freestyle and stuff, because if I know the song, I'm not going to react to it. You know, I want to react to music that I don't know and first time hearing it. Like this one, prime example. Alternative rock band R.E.M. released in 1993 as a fifth single from the group's eighth album, Automatic for the People, 1992. And it's a ballad, guys, that features Michael Stipe, accompanied by the bassist Mike Mills on piano. And it was credited the whole band as usual. The string arrangement by the former Led Zeppelin bassist Jean-Paul Jones, and prominent oboe by Deborah Workman in the latter part of the piece. Beautifully done, beautifully orchestrated, beautiful production in terms of instrumentation. And even his voice is good too. There's really no chorus in this song. There's no chorus. It's just a whole bunch of verses. And he's just singing through, kind of like going about, you know, the process of this song, and allowing you to appreciate the instrumentation at the same time. And that's the thing about it. Really, really good. It's just good on the ears. So here's the thing. Here's the different meanings, guys. I told you one already. The inspiration of the song, here's another, has been debated by band members. Stipe, in a 2001 Esquire article, suggested that the origin of the song a few years ago, I wanted to write a song about night watchmen. So I hired one guard, the REM offices in Athens. I bought a uniform and a flashlight and everything. He turned out to be kind of crazy and called me up in the middle of the night and to tell me dirty stories about the Kennedys. I wrote the song about him, but I was so paranoid that he said that he was going to sue me. So I changed the lyric from Night Watchman to Night Swimming. That's interesting. Wow. I wonder if that one's true. Conversely, in a post, Mills said it's based on true events, exploring a shot early in 1980s REM and the circle of friends who would go skinny dipping after the Athens clubs closed that night. We go to parties, we go to the clubs, and we go to the ball pump, and there will be any number of these same 50 people. So it was a very tight circle of friends. Peter Buck holds a similar interpretation. However, Stipe says that he had denied that it is any topic of the song. Rather, Stipe says that it's a song about a kind of innocence that's either kind of desperately clung onto or obviously lost. Stipe said that there was an autobiographical elements to the song, but insists that it's mostly made up. Very interesting. So anybody can interpret it any way you want. You know, I guess that's kind of like when it comes down to. And there you have it. Very interesting song, guys. Very interesting song. Please let me know what you guys think. I would love to hear what you have to say about this one and R.E.M. in general. Please let me know. Have my ears open. I will definitely check out the comments and see what you have to say, guys. Take care. Until next time for more videos like these, guys. Take care. Hey, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you'd like to see more videos like these, be sure to check this one out. And also take a moment to comment, like, and smash the subscribe button to stay on all the latest reaction videos. And guys, yes, I have a Patreon link. Be sure to check that out when you get a chance. Help support my channel. Makes recommendations like the one you just saw all the more possible. All right, guys. Take care. Love you guys. Peace.